Blackstone Audio presents A License to Steal by Walter T. Shaw with Mary Jane Robinson. Forward. Redemption. To carry out. Make good. Fulfill. We redeem a promise by doing what we said we would do. This is what A License to Steal is all about. Full of love, fear, violence, hate, and the quest for redemption, this book is an unbelievable journey through life. Walter T. Shaw has been and is still on a journey that would fill 10 men's lifetimes. From his early years as a boy growing up in a life full of turmoil, he watched his father, Walter L. Shaw, a true electronics genius, taken advantage of by the powers that be. Shaw Jr. was indelibly stamped with resentment and rage against them. This hatred turned the youngster into a man driven by vengeance to right the wrong that the world was doing to his father. Though he worked tirelessly and legitimately to create his next breakthrough invention, Walter Sr. had the responsibility of a family to feed. He did whatever it took to keep them from going hungry, sometimes crossing over to the illegitimate side in desperation. In rebellion, Shaw Jr. decided to live his life on the wrong side after meeting some of the people who had hurt his father. Most people are a little fearful of Walter Shaw because of his criminal background. Way down deep, though, he is a real, sincere person. Unfortunately, his honesty and sincerity are questioned because of his past, and he doesn't let too many people in. I met him around 1998 or 1999 through a mutual friend, and we talked about the movie he was producing based on this story. Walter asked me to play Anthony, a main character in the book, and I agreed because the script was so well written. A few years later, he invited me to come to Florida to pay tribute to his dad. Shaw Sr.'s 39 patents were finally recognized, and Yakov Heller's bust of him was unveiled that day. That's when I really became a friend of Walter's, realizing this journey he'd been on to redeem his relationship with his father. This book will take you on the ride of your life. You will cry, you will laugh, and you will feel the love a family can have for one another, regardless of their circumstances. On a personal level, I can't wait to make the movie, A License to Steal. It's been a long time coming. Frank Vincent, September 2007. No one's life can be encompassed in one telling. There is no way to give each year its allotted weight, to include each event, each person who helped to shape a lifetime. What can be done is to be faithful in spirit to the record and try to find one's way to the heart of the individual. Author unknown. Part 1. Injustice. Preface to Part 1. If I can draw it, I can make it. Walter L. Shaw. My father had a favorite saying, "If I can draw it, I can make it." He always drew little sketches of his inventions first. "Thiel," he used to tell me, "if it works on paper, it'll work when I build it." And most of the time it did. Even more amazing was the fact that he could think of it. As early as the 1940s, 1950s, and 1960s, who was thinking of speakerphones, conference calls, or call forwarding? My dad was ahead of the world by decades. His mind was going all the time. It still hurts me to admit this, but as a kid, I had no interest in what my father was doing. There was nothing in me that was curious about any of it. You know, show me what those two wires do. Nothing. That stuff bored me. I was proud of his inventions, and I thought it was great that his mind could come up with those things, but show me how that works? Never. I remember sitting at the kitchen table when he was building his models and making plastic cases. He put his inventions in plastic cases to demonstrate how they worked, and just like his drawings, those cases were everywhere. They were glued together with model airplane glue, and the smell of that in the house was horrible. I can still see my dad sitting over there in his spaghetti strap t-shirts just making those things. He sat there for hours and did that by himself, all hunched over with his hair. Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.